Hello all, welcome to the Pandas for Pentesters course at Pentester Academy. Now in this video, we are going to look at an extremely interesting and powerful feature of Pandas called split, apply and combine. So what is split, apply and combine, and where does Groupby come in? So we'll get into that in just a bit, but before that, let's try and conceptually understand why we need this feature. Now, whenever you look at a large data set, most of the times you probably want to go ahead and look at behavior of certain groups within the data set. So as an example, if I were scanning the entire Wi-Fi network and getting a huge list of SSIDs and encryption schemas being used by those SSIDs, then maybe I want to do an analysis on all networks called office network, which of course have the same SSID and hence belong to the same group. But many of those APs may have different encryption mechanisms turned on, such as WEP, WPA, PSK, WPA Enterprise, etc. Right? Now, this is really where Pandas provides an extremely strong support to work with such group level operations. I would highly recommend clicking on the link below and visiting the Pandas help page. There is a massive amount of information there on how to use Groupby. In this video and the next, I'm going to be touching upon some of the more common and important methods which I feel we would end up using from an InfoSec perspective when we analyze data sets. Okay, so what is split, apply, and combine? Now, this image, of course, has been taken from a Stack Overflow question. So let's actually visualize a very simple data set. So let's say you have keys and you have data, right? The keys are A, B, and C. And of course, you have corresponding data to that. And let's assume all of this is mixed into the data set in some way. Now, let's say you are for some reason interested in figuring out some behavior about the group A and the group B and C separately, then how do you go about it? Now, this is really where we will have to split the data first by group. So as an example, we've split the data here and we can see we have a group with all the keys set to A. In this group, we have all the keys as B, and in this group, C. Now, once we have done this split using typically a Groupby operation in Pandas, the next step is to decide what to do with this group. Now, in Pandas, what we want to do after this is apply some kind of an operation on these group elements. So as an example, we could take the sum, the mean, find the max, find the min, or even apply a completely custom function. So as an example, if let's say our apply operation is a sum, then what Pandas does is in each of these groups, it's going to sum up all the values. So 0, 5, and 10 is 15. 5, 10, and 15 is 30. And then 10, 15, and 20 is 45. So it takes the sum individually within each of these groups in the apply operation, and then combines them together and gives you this new data frame where you get this consolidated statistical information about A, B, and C. In this case, the statistic we are interested in is the sum of all values within each of the individual groups A, B, and C, right? So we are going to be working using this principle. Again, very simple, split the entire data set based on some criteria, and then for each of those little groups, apply some function, and then combine all the results together and get it back as a new data frame which you can work with. Now, as simple as this looks like, this is extremely powerful in the real world. Let's go ahead and take an example. So I'm going into my machine. Let's go full screen. Now I'm going to be using the data frame Groupby IPython notebook. You can download the same from below the video if you're watching this on Pentester Academy, or else this should come with the core zip file. So let me launch this. Great, and I'm going to quickly clear all the cells. Now, the first thing we are going to look at is the data set itself, right? So I'm using what is called the Iris data set. Now, interestingly, this is a very, very common and used data set in the world of machine learning and introductory data science. Now, what is this data set? Well, there seems to be different subspecies of flowers. And we have measurements of the sepal length, the sepal width, the petal length, and the petal width of each of these species. And from our purpose, we are going to go ahead and look at how we can run different split, apply, and combine operations on this, right? So if we scroll down, we see a bunch of measurements, and the species we can see setosa. We can see versicolor and then virginica, right? We can see clearly there are three different species over here. Great. Let's go back. Now let's run this code together. So first, of course, is all the imports. Let's run that. Wait for a bit. We are seeing the asterisk sign here. Now let's actually import the Iris data set. Because we have an extremely well formatted CSV file, it seems to be very well behaved. We could just use the read CSV method in Pandas to read the CSV and print out the top five, or rather the first five elements. There we go. Now, because this file seems to be arranged by species, at the very top, what we see is setosa. Now, if I were to look at the column names, I would find them to be sepal length, sepal width, petal length, and petal width, followed by the species. Now, if you wanted to quickly find out the number of species in there, we can just use the set operation on the species column. And there we go. We have setosa, versicolor, and virginica. Great. So now let's look at some very basic operations, right? So if you recall, the very first operation is to split this by different groups. Now, if I go back here, what is the most logical way to split this into different groups? By species, of course. Right? So we would want, let's say, some kind of an average statistic, maybe for the sepal length by species, as an example. So Pandas has a simple method called Groupby, where you can actually go ahead and mention the column or the list of columns using which the Groupby operation should work. In this case, I'm just going to go and do a Groupby by species. Oops. Now, if you notice, unlike in the data frame case, when we run Groupby, I really am not seeing anything broken up into groups. All I seem to get back is this nasty little message which just tells me, hey, all I'm going to give you back is a little Groupby object. Now, this is typical for a group by operation, and we'll have to work on this group by object to get some sensible things out of it. Okay. Now, one of the first things, of course, is let me go ahead and assign this to a variable iris group, and then let me print out the indices of the iris group. There we go. So if you notice, we can now see three distinct groups emerge: Setosa, Versicolor, and Virginica, right? And of course, these are the original indexes between 0 to 49, 50 to 99, and 100 to 149. Okay. Now let's look at the keys. Of course, there are going to be three groups and hence three keys. And let's look at the values. And these are nothing but the indexes, which in our case, because we are starting at 0, the row indexes and basically our kind of pandas index kind of matches in value. Okay. Now, one of the first things we are going to try here is basically iterating through this group object. Now, we can do an iteration just we would like in the case of a dictionary for k, v, and then let's print the value of k and v. I've created two delimiters on the top and the bottom which says new group starts and ends, just so that we can see the output a little better. There we go. So the first group is Setosa. And as you can clearly see within that, we have all the values set for Setosa. Great. The next group is Versicolor. And similarly, we can see all the columns in here for the species Versicolor. And then finally, similarly for Virginica. Fantastic. Now, another way by which we can quickly visualize the group by object is to use the list method. So we can hit an enter, and there we go. We see that Setosa is the first one. Then you have Versicolor. And then finally, Virginica. Alternately, you can also do a dot groups. This seems to give you similar output for Setosa, but again, this actually gives you just the original row indexes, not very helpful, unlike the list one, which actually showed us all the values as well. Finally, there is an operation called get underscore group, which allows you to selectively get individual groups out of the group by object. There you go. So we've selectively taken out Setosa, and here we actually find all the data just for Setosa. Fantastic. So in this video, what we've seen is how we can apply the split operation of breaking up the larger data set into smaller groups using a pandas method called group by. Now, in the next video, we are going to look at apply and combine together. So let's go back. So that's all I had in mind for this video. See you in the next one. And if you're enjoying your time at Pentester Academy, please do recommend us to your friends and colleagues in the InfoSec community. Thank you.